Greetings in the name of matchless Jesus Christ. It is indeed a joy once again to meet you through this short video and podcast. One question. How many of you have been asking yourself or telling others that God is done with me? I don't seem to be in God's plan. God is not interested in me anymore because I've been waiting here for I never know how long, and nothing seems to be moving. I'm stagnant in all my life, maybe my corporate life, my personal life, my spiritual life, my family life. Everything is stagnant. I don't see anything happening. I don't see anything moving forward. If that's your question, my dear brother, my dear sister, young people watching this video or listening to the podcast, I have an answer for you. All right. There are multiple reasons why you might go through this situation, but we are going to see two major reasons. The reason why I call it major reasons are because it's been a reason for me to go through this situation years or decades before. So I'm sure this would definitely help you. Are you ready? Here we go. First thing. Are you in the place that God wants you to be? Because, you know, when God created or established a plan for Adam, all right, God said, Adam, I'm going to make a man out of mud. I'm going to place him in the Eden garden. So when God establishes a plan for you, he also defines a place for you. Now, God said, Adam, you be in this garden. You rule over this garden. From every plant, from every bird, every creature, every animal, whatever God created, he said you will rule over it. So that was God's plan, and that was God's place to establish God's plan. Now what happened when Adam was chased out of the Eden garden is a history, and everybody knows that story. You know it, right? He had to go through a lot of trouble because he was out of the place where God planted him to establish God's plan. So the first point is, we need to be in the place where God wants us to be for God's plan to be established. You remember Jonah? God wanted him to go to Tarshish, and you know where he went. And you know what happened when he went to Nineveh, don't you? So the place where God designs for you, it's very prominent, it's very important for you to stay in that place for God's plan to be fulfilled in your life. But if you want to be in your place and want God's plan to be fulfilled, take my words, mark my words, it will not happen. You have to come back to the same question or same doubt, that is God still interested in me? Is God's plan still working for me? You would continue to have this question because you are in the plan of God, but not in the place where God wants you to be to fulfill his plans. Does that make sense? You get what I mean? You understand what I'm trying to explain? So first thing, although you are in the plan of God, definitely everyone God created, God has a plan. That is no doubt about it. Absolutely no doubt. But are you in the place where God wants you to be for his plan to be fulfilled? Ask yourself. Second question. The second question is, when God reveals a plan to you in secret, it means it needs to be kept secret. You cannot go ahead and share, no matter how close your friends are, no matter how close your relatives are, no matter how close the person that you trust is, when God secretly gives you a plan, you have to maintain the secrecy. Because God trusts you and he tells you. You remember Samson? God told him, you cannot shave. You cannot shave your head. You cannot have strong things because that's where your power is. But what did Samson do? You know the story, Delilah, he revealed And you know what happened to him after that? Not everybody around you are so excited about your growth. Not everybody around you are excited about your prosperity. Not everybody wants you to be blessed. I'm not blaming people around you, but God has a purpose for, when he tells you this plan in secret, he has a purpose. That's why he tells it in secret. Or else he could have had a stage set up and he would have had the loudest of loudspeakers, microphones, and he would have told the world about what he's going to do to you and to me. But when we pray to God, God tells us something we need to do the way God wants us to do. And if we do this, two things. There are a lot of other things, but two things are very important. It played a vital role in my life, my personal life, for me to grow from where I was to where I am right now. These two things helped me a lot. First, stay in the place where God wants you to stay. Second, until the plan is fulfilled, keep it within you. God knows who needs to know. So God wants you to know. So you know it. You don't want the world to know about it. That makes sense? You want to revisit your life? You want to relate this with your corporate life, about your promotions that you discussed, or with your family you discussed about some event of your life and it messed up? Can you relate? I'm sure you can relate this. Now don't ever doubt if God still remembers you, God still has a plan for you or not, because God in Leviticus 26:42, this is what the God says, all right? I will remember my covenant with Jacob. I will remember my covenant with Isaac. I will remember my covenant with Abraham, and I will remember the land, is what God says. You know when God told this? Hundreds of years after Jacob, Isaac, and Abraham left this world. They were not there. They were not alive. But still, God remembers the covenant that he made with them. And if God can remember the covenant that he had with people who are not alive, wouldn't he still remember the covenant that he made with you and me, my dear people? My dear beloved brothers and sisters, don't even doubt. God remembers the covenant he made with you and me. And he will definitely fulfill. Stay in the place God wants you to stay and maintain the secrecy. Allow him to work in your life. Because you know how hard it is for Adam to stay out of the Garden of Eden. And how hard it is for Jonah to be in the belly of a fish. How hard it is for Samson to lose all his power. Do we really want to go through that phase? No, I really don't want to go. And I believe you don't want to go through that phase. So that's your confirmation as well. Be in the place where God has planted you. And hold on to the plan within yourself that God has given you. All right. Can we pray? Our dear loving Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord Jesus, for a reconfirmation that you still have plans for us. We are still in the center of your plan, and you haven't forgotten the covenant that you have made with us, O Father. Help us, Lord, to stay in the place that you have destined for us and to hold on to all our promises within us until it's been fulfilled. We would go ahead and express it only as a testimony after it has been fulfilled. We thank you. We give you all praise, glory, and honor. And in Jesus' matchless name, we thank and pray. Amen, amen, and amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful month ahead.